My pappy said, son, you're gonna drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln. Have you heard the story of the hot rod race when the Fords and the Lincolns were setting the pace? That story is true, I'm here to say, 'cause I was driving that Model A. It's got a Lincoln motor and it's really souped up, and that Model A body makes it look like a pup. It's got 8 cylinders and uses them all. Got overdrive, just won't stall. With 4 bow carbs and a dual exhaust and 411 gears, you can really get lost. Got safety tubes, but I ain't scared. The brakes are good, the tires fair. Pulled out of San Pedro late one night, the moon and the stars were shining bright. We was driving up old Grapevine Hill, passing cars like they were standing still.
What's up, Styrene Slingers, Bodacious Rods and Customs, coming at you with a new kit. Yes, folks, we have a new kit on the bench here at the Bodacious Rods and Customs shop. And I'm here to introduce it to you today. It is the AMT Fruit Wagon, which is a pretty neat kit, mainly because it comes with a variety of different setup schemes. It's actually what they call a build two out of 4 different ways, all in one box, guys. So if you're into kit bashing and you'd love to have a parts bin full of good pieces, especially if you're into rat rods, T-buckets, and things like that, you're going to find a boatload of parts. 4 different ways that you can build it, and enough parts to build 2 cars straight from this box. If you're into kit bashing with other things and going after the Cranky's Gold, then you're in luck, because you can go crazy with a kit like this, guys. Anyway, yeah, I'm real psyched about that one. My totally awesome girl, Kathleen, took me out. She heard that the Doctor Cranky Calendar was up and running, and then there was a theme. So she's like, why don't we go check out a new kit? So together we picked that one, and we have yet to decide what exactly is going to happen and how we're going to enter it. But for now, that's going to be my Doctor Cranky's Calendar 2016 entry. It'll be my first entry into a Cranky Calendar, so I'm real excited about that. But guys, check this out. I haven't even opened the bags, because it would literally be silly to do so. There would be parts everywhere. Full tilt pieces here that you can put together the whole fruit wagon bit. You can go for a T-roadster pieces over here. You've got a chrome tree that's just totally set up. I guess it comes with a stock Ford engine and a Lincoln V8, perhaps. Not entirely sure. But a lot of guys talk about kits and their quality, and this is going to be my first AMT kit that I can recall personally. Thus far, I've done pretty much Monogram and Revell kits, and I've been reasonably pleased with what comes out of the box. And there has been some variety as to the quality of the overall open box. When you get it going, you have to work some stuff out, but that's kind of the nature of the beast. So I'm sure that once I break into these bags and start finding things and figuring out how they're going to fit, it's going to leave me doing a little bit of work. But stuff that you find in these AMT boxes that guys may or may not notice is, I don't know how y'all feel about it, but I think that the wheels that come in an AMT kit, they're outstanding. They look great. The, I guess they've got pad-printed logos on them for Goodyears. They look good. They've got white walls. They've got blue streak racing slicks for your cheater slicks, fad T styles. And it even came with the set for the old-school rickety Tin Lizzie type setup. So, I mean, you can really build whatever you want with this kit. And it came with enough glass to do two T's, so that's pretty cool. What it didn't come with was a whole lot of instructions. So for 4 different ways of building a model, you've got literally front and back of a page to look at, and no exhaustive parts list of what's on the trees, what to expect. It's kind of a learn as you go thing. So if you're planning on doing this kit, I would strongly recommend familiarizing yourself with the kit and mocking it up several times from beginning to end, in strictly in styrene, just to get it going and make sure you've got everything going. I mean, I haven't even opened the bag yet, so I'm not speaking from any experience other than a few models that I've done recently, but I think that this is the type of thing that proper planning is going to be the way to alleviate headaches later on. The chrome tree looks pretty cool. I haven't started snipping things off, so I'm not sure where they attached everything, but I find that sometimes the strategy of mounting these pieces can be a little harrowing when it comes to like leaving highly visible places where you're clipping chrome off of the tree. And it's almost impossible to fix it without, you know, destroying more chrome or just totally ripping the whole thing and re-chroming it yourself with, you know, expensive lacquers, which, hey, a lot of us really like to do that. But sometimes, you know, you'd like to just be able to leave the chrome alone, put it on there, and it still look convincing and accurate, you know. It's built to be chrome. It ought to look good. What's cool here is we got some decals. I would be hard-pressed to use any of these because I just don't see myself building it in this kind of box stock kind of set. I feel like if I were to do that truck, I would have a dramatically more thematic way of doing it. So what I might use these is as a template for making my own decals, I think, perhaps for this car. And that way, if I'm going to go ahead and dusty it up real good, we will have the proper sizes. So that's what we're going to do with those decals. We'll probably put those in the archive and move on with that. But anyway, guys, there we have it. The newest addition to the Bodacious Rods and Customs family, the 25T Fruit Wagon Roadster 2 and 4. Here's another shot of the bottom of that box. I really like the box art on this thing. I don't know, for some reason I find myself sort of attached to the box, even after the model's long since been built. It's almost more visible to see the box than the model itself. But it's a cool little vintage, real hip kind of styling that they got going on for this thing. So I think they get some style points at the very least for giving something that's at least sort of fetching to have in your shop to work at and look at while you're building your new hot rod. Anyway, guys, so that's that. Bodacious Rods and Customs. Still working on the other cars. Everything's got a lot of scratch work to do, and I'm really excited. I've got some new products in the house to use. Went ahead and got me some plastic weld. I'm so stoked about that because I feel like I'm going to have a lot more confident bonds, especially in my scratch building, when it comes to running headers and fixing frames and building roadsters and rat roadsters specifically out of things like this, because you know, the parts that come straight out of the kit are going to be awesome. I'm sure I can make some really cool stuff straight out of this box stock, but I really prefer to go crazy, and I've always had had it in my mind to make a radical T, and now is my chance to put all those ideas to work and see what we get. So follow along, guys. Build number 3 underway here in Bodacious Rods and Customs shop. And I'm super glad to have you guys on board with it, and I'll keep you guys posted as we go. Sparingly, of course, once we get down to the end, it'll get a little bit more secretive, as per the request of Mr. Dr. Cranky himself. But that's what we're working on, guys, and I hope you guys enjoy watching the build as we go, and I'm just so psyched to have an opportunity to show my models with the amazing group of peers that we have here on the YouTube modeling community. Everybody's been really, really supportive. If you haven't checked out his page, I don't know how you know where my page is if you don't know who Dr. Cranky is, but if you are watching this and you don't know who Dr. Cranky is, I'm going to put a link at the very bottom for him, hopefully, and you guys should go check out his page. He is a giver and a mentor, and a true patron of this art, and a hero to many of us. So check out his page if you haven't, God forbid. I can't imagine how you could be this deep into this to actually watch YouTube videos while building models and not know who Dr. Cranky is. But hey, anyway, guys, Bodacious Rods and Customs out. Glad to have you on board, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.
All of a sudden, in the wink of an eye, a Cadillac sedan passed us by. I said, boys, that's a mark from me. By then, the taillight was all you could see. Now the fellas all ribbed me for being behind, so I thought I'd make that Lincoln unwind. Took my foot off the gas, and man alive, I shoved it on down into overdrive. Well, I wound it up to 110. My speedometer said that I'd hit top end. My foot was glued like lead to the floor. That's all there is, there ain't no more. Now the boys all thought that I'd lost my sense, and them telephone poles looked like a picket fence. They said, slow down, I see spots. The lines on the road just look like dots. We took a corner, sideswiped the truck, and I crossed my fingers just for luck. My fenders was clicking the guardrail post, and the guy beside me was white as a ghost.